Hey, what's going on, guys? I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm Dr. Boyce Watkins from Your Black World and the Black Business School. I wanted to address something. You guys know I address things that all things black and financial. And so one of the things I wanted to address, which I think is both black and financial, which is Mr. Bill Cosby. Now, Father's Day just happened, and you know my point of view. My point of view is that a part of the reason our community struggles is because we've lost a lot of our fathers. A lot of our fathers were taken down through things like mass incarceration, economic disparity, things like that. I also believe we need to fight back. I think that we have to basically claim our sovereignty as black people, meaning that we can't let other people tell us who we are or what we believe or what we think is important and what matters. Well, Bill Cosby, as you guys know, he's the comedian, the disgraced comedian who had millions and millions of dollars in his bank account, who was incarcerated with no evidence. For a situation that involved an alleged groping of a woman, for to whom he had already paid over $3 million, and the incarceration was unjust. It was unjust not because I think Cosby's a perfect guy, because he's innocent. It was unjust because there was no evidence, there was no proof that he did it. Now, black men are, to my knowledge, the only group of people in America who can be incarcerated without any proof, just with somebody's accusation. you can't do that to a white female. So Cosby, who has been put in prison, there are millions of people that are hoping that he's going to die in prison. Millions of people who are happy to lynch him publicly, which is part of a long tradition of lynching black men for being accused of touching a white woman. If you guys, in case you guys don't recall this, Black Wall Street was burned down. All of Black Wall Street was burned down. Hundreds of people were, shot, killed, had their wealth stolen, billions of dollars in wealth stolen, which would have become billions of dollars in wealth over time. It was all stolen, and houses looted, people killed, locked up, and incarcerated because a black man was accused of touching a white woman. So there's something sacred in the minds of white Americans to this day about the white woman's body. If you look at it, you touch it, you're accused of going near it, then you can get many years in prison, especially as a black man. That's why Albert Wilson, if you look up the website freealbertwilson.com, Albert Wilson is a 23-year-old college student who had no criminal record whatsoever, had never even, from what I understand, gotten in trouble for anything in his life, was basically hit on by a white woman who wanted to sleep with him. They were alone for 5 minutes. He never penetrated her. He kissed her. There was saliva on her chest from the kiss. He claims that she was upset that he wouldn't have sex with her. They were alone for 5 minutes, so sex couldn't happen, didn't happen. And she claimed that there was an assault, but there was no evidence to justify his incarceration. Yet Albert Wilson is now serving 12 years in prison. That's the only kind of sentence that can that sentence can only happen to a black man. As D.L. Hughley said, and I agree with him. He said a black man can be accused of almost anything, and people will believe it. And I believe D.L. And I agree with DL. So anyway, where does this go back to Cosby? Well, with Cosby, you've got a guy who where because he's now been incarcerated and disgraced, people believe he has no value. There are a lot of white Americans, a lot of people, period, believe that Cosby is completely worthless. They believe he has no value to society. And I think the black community has a different perspective. Not every black person, but a lot of black people see him as a person who might have done some things he shouldn't have done. But a lot of the people, Bill Clinton has probably done just as much as Bill Cosby ever did. Donald Trump certainly has done as much as Bill Cosby ever did. So it doesn't make any of these guys good guys, but it does kind of speak to the double standard that exists. So Cosby puts up this Father's Day message where he basically just wishes people happy Father's Day and encourages them to be their best self, to step to the plate, to be good fathers. And he gets trashed for it on social media. Everybody's like, the nerve of you, the audacity of you, blah, 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 blah. Well, what you're really hearing there is you're hearing basically racial lynch mobs speaking. Racial lynch mobs are where you've got millions of people who are infected with the disease of racism and a hatred for the black man, a fear of the black man, which drives the hatred, where they come out with pitchforks and they come out in mobs to take down black men. And many of these individuals are liberal. Actually, the conservatives are a little less willing, or it's ironic though. But a lot of the support that Cosby actually receives to this day actually comes from the right more so than the left. Not because people on the right love black people, but because they believe in little things like providing evidence before you go lock somebody up. Whereas liberals kind of believe that because you have feelings, because you feel something's bad, or because you feel a person's bad, you should have the right to just tear them down, destroy their, you know, destroy their life or whatever, just based on the court of public opinion. Like, we're all just going to attack you, and then we're going to bully you into the ground, and we're going to kill your rights and freedoms and freedom of speech and everything else, because we have a specific agenda in mind. We have a goal in mind. So if you ask me, you know, am I liberal? I say no. If you say, are you conservative? I say no. The people say, well, what are you? I say, well, I'm black, right? I'm not liberal or conservative. I'm black. I can't support the liberals if they back things like the Me Too movement, not because I don't believe that there is a legitimate reason to deal with things like assault or gender bias, but because I don't believe in the idea of incarcerating people when you don't have evidence. I think that that's a severe violation of American civil liberties, basic civil liberties. That's a very dangerous precedent in our society. You can't lock people up because you feel like they might be a bad person. So Cosby, here's the thing. Cosby is still a relevant and valuable member of the black community, whether white people like this or not. Cosby is in prison. He's mentoring those young men who have been forgotten by society. Many of those young men were locked up by people like Bill Clinton, locked up by people like Hillary Clinton, locked up by people like Joe Biden. In the 1994 crime bill, they've been forgotten. They are prisoners of war, not because they're innocent, not because they never made a mistake, but white people make the same mistakes and they are running around free. White people have made those same mistakes and they got good jobs. White people have made those mistakes and they've been allowed to become husbands and fathers and wives and mothers and live a normal life. Black people are the only group of people where you make a mistake, you slang a little dope when you're 18 years old, and you get 45, 60, 70, 80 years in prison. So a lot of these individuals have been forgotten by society, but those are our men. Those are our fathers. Those are the men that we need in our community. So Cosby is doing a tremendous service to the black community by going in that prison and saying, despite the fact that he probably has some personal failings, despite the fact that he was into some crazy partying in the 60s where everybody was using those drugs. You know, we don't know the difference between drug addicts. If a drug addict says somebody drugged me, nobody knows. Did you take the drugs voluntarily or did you not take the drugs voluntarily? In the 60s, a lot of people were getting into the Quaaludes and all this other stuff. Janice Dickerson is a known drug addict and she's saying that he drugged me. Well, it's not to say that it's right, not to say that it's okay to do that, but to say that you have no proof. You have no evidence. You filed no police reports. You were taking money from this man. You were friends with him for many years afterward. You were telling your friends you were using him for money. And when you couldn't use him for money anymore, then suddenly you converted yourself into a victim, which is a privilege, which is an example of white female privilege. A white female privilege means that I can go from being predator to victim back to predator, and no one will know the difference because they always see me as innocent. They always see me as sacred. They see me as high and mighty and above and better than everybody else. Black men can't do the same thing. So I'm not here to defend Bill Cosby. I actually have been a critic of Bill Cosby in the past, especially when he got all self-righteous with the pound cake speech and all that. I felt that represented a lack of connection to what people in the community are going through. But one area where I vibe with Cosby 100% is, one, he shouldn't be in prison because you have no proof. You can't lock people up based on what you think they did. You have to lock them up based on what you can prove. Two, Cosby is not a guy who never did a good thing in the world. Cosby is, to this day, the greatest donor to HBCUs in history, other than Robert Smith, who just gave the $40 million student loan gift. But even Cosby's gift back in the 1980s, if you convert it to 2019 dollars, he matches Robert Smith. So he and Robert Smith stand above all the other celebrities out here talking all this yin-yang about how they love HBCUs and all this stuff. Ain't none of them stepped up and gave that kind of loot to support black students. None of them. So Cosby, you know, Cosby created the Cosby Show. He created a different world. He created Fat Albert, all of which were designed to elevate the condition of black people everywhere. Now, even if you think Cosby's a bad man, even if you think he's a bad man, even if you think he's a bad man, that's okay. It's your right to believe that. But you cannot say that at the very least, he's not a bad man who did some good things for the community. Cosby has done some wonderful things for the black community. Cosby is doing wonderful things for the black community. Cosby is behind bars mentoring the young men that are your brothers, your sisters, your siblings, your spouses, your baby daddies, whoever, and making them better for the black community when they come home. And for that reason, I support him. He has every right to give a Father's Day message, and I'm glad he still refers to himself as America's dad, because as far as I'm concerned, he's still America's dad, even if even if some white woman accused him of committing a crime. So that's my two cents on Cosby. I'm done. Please hit the thumbs up button, hit the share button, hit the subscribe button. Feel free to disagree with me if you want to. I'm not changing my opinion for nobody. That's all it is. If you want a free e-copy of my book, It Takes a Village to Raise the Bar, go to drboycewatkins.net. That's drboycewatkins.net. I'm Dr. Boyce Watkins. Take care. Have a good day. I'll see you guys soon. Be good. Peace.